What could go wrong? Insert hate montage of agony. I shouldn't say rode. We pushed bikes and pushed bikes. But this loon saw us and beelined it right for us. I was like, Josh, paddle faster!
Sweet cheese steak, bear brats.
They proved to be not super great for us. There was a lot of smoke in the air from the nearby fire.
There's gonna be no way that we're gonna be able to go back.
Because of the cart, we had fishing waders, we had a fishing pole, lures.
Nah, 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 I ain't dead yet.
I love to adventure, and the filmmaking and the photography allow me to capture those moments and helps for me to share it with other people. My name's Dan Redfield, and these are my photo ventures.
The drive out to Resurrection Pass is absolutely beautiful. You pass by the Turnagain Arm, you get to see views of the mountains, the water, and then we pull up past Cooper Landing and then find our place to park. So just a couple of days ago, we did this CrossFit exercise and they had us doing burpees. I've never done a burpee before. So I did like, I don't know, like 5,000 burpees. My legs are still killing me. Josh has already taken this trip once before. So we had a good idea of what we needed to pack for. So I pulled out the camera and, you know, we were just joking. Our spirits were high and we had absolutely no idea what we were in for.
Have you adventured with me before?
I have not. This is the first time.
So you know my reputation?
No, I do not.
Wait, hang on a second. What reputation? Not that reputation, the other reputation.
So from here, 12 to 14 miles in for day one, stay at that cabin. Then we have a 2-mile canoe ride to our second cabin. And then on the third day, on Thursday, we'll have to canoe back over the 2 miles and then ride the bikes back in the 12 or 14 miles. As long as we don't see any bears, bust our bikes, and run out of memory cards and batteries, I mean, what could go wrong?
What could go wrong? Gotcha.
Insert hate montage of agony.
And I can't understand why you did me like you done. I feel the demons inside, I'm staring at the sun. Will somebody come save me? The siren, she played me.
I don't know how to like say this without throwing him under the bus. You know what I mean? Josh has taken this trail a few times before. When I asked him what should we bring and how heavy should we pack, he said, well, we're gonna be on bikes. So if you have a bike cart, you know, the trail should be good enough for you to bring a bike cart along, which clearly that was a mistake.
You know, Josh, what I think it is, it's not the lack of high performance tires and the fact that they're not fully inflated to the manufacturer's complete recommendation. I feel like it's almost like a weight thing, like back here.
Almost like you're pulling something?
Yeah, it's not so much here, and it's not so much there, but like right there. GoPro, stop recording.
From time to time, we would take a little pit stop from pushing our bikes and check out some of the pretty flowers. So the flowers that are out right now are these purple lupin, and I think there's just something kind of magical about taking pictures of flowers. They're an easy subject, they don't talk back, and they're just kind of fun to shoot.
Suppress while you sleep, I'm swelling with violence with no time to breathe. Your anger and temper tend to get the best of me. And maybe you hold too hard, maybe I'll go too far. But I am a gun, I am a gun, I am a wish I can't be
alone. You know, photography is a learning process, and I think the best thing that you can do is look at what you shot in the past, learn what you did right, what you potentially did wrong, and then use that knowledge moving forward. Juneau Creek Falls is one of the main attractions out there, and I love shooting waterfalls, I love shooting moving water. One of the things that I always look for is how can you use nature to kind of help frame your subjects. So for instance, here we had trees in the surrounding area, so I used this kind of vignette little circle that the tree was making, and then I framed up the waterfalls using that. And I think anytime you can incorporate one, the foreground, and two, a little bit of natural framing, just helps to add more dimension into your frame. Getting a little bit closer to our destination, we crossed by Juneau Lake. Because there was a lot of smoke in the air from a nearby fire, it added a lot of drama into the sky. One of the basic rules of photography is when you're shooting with a horizon line, you're not supposed to put your horizon line right in the middle. You're supposed to kind of follow the rules of thirds and either place your horizon line in the top third or the bottom third of your composition. Like with any rules, rules are meant to be broken, right? And the one reason why I would break that rule is if you have a perfect reflection in the lake and you could almost kind of flip it one way or the other, it turns the composition into somewhat of a symmetrical one. So the trail conditions. I shouldn't say road. We pushed bikes and pushed bikes and pushed bikes.
Run to the battle, run to the end. They coming for me. Say a prayer, my friend. I'm rising up.
We went from possibly, you know, a 3-hour bike ride in to a 10-hour catastrophe, hate your life scenario, which is what it was.
Eye of the tiger, the living beast within. Ah, don't go off. Oh, you suck. You suck. Ugh.
We hit the trailhead at 12 o'clock. We didn't get into the cabin until 10 o'clock at night. We set up camp and got some food cooking right away, and we hadn't really eaten a whole lot that day.
Breakfast burritos for the morning. All ready to go.
So Josh had brought some bear brats, but they proved to be not super great for us in the future.
There's no other way to put it. Last night sucked. Think of it like dragging a suitcase through a gravel path for 15 miles. It was like that, but heavier. We definitely underestimated the trail and definitely overpacked by an insane amount. But that does mean we have coffee. It's good. But there's gonna be no way that we're gonna be able to go back with that trailer. Because we overpacked and because we had brought the trailer with all the extra room for all the goodies, that means we eat like kings and I get to wear all my favorite outfits. Jump cut to me wearing all my different outfits. Get this shot on land? Of course you could. But I didn't pack my water shoes just to leave them in the luggage case. The next morning we took a canoe to the other side of the lake. We actually weren't supposed to do that. Cabin is a fly-in only. Which we actually didn't know. So definitely don't do that. But we did because we're kind of stupid.
You can hide where you want to. You can run where you may. But nothing on earth gonna save you when the man comes down your way.
Nailed it. Got it.
On our way over to the other side, we ran into a little loon. This loon saw us, sought us out, and beelined it right for us. You know, this loon had some issues. She was letting us know, like, we are way too close to her nest, and we need to get away. And we're like, dude, we're way out here. Like, you don't need to be worried about us, but... She was like swimming right by us and like squawking at us, and I was like, I'm sorry. I was like, Josh, paddle faster. She's like, nah, 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 nah. Long story short, we kind of got our butts kicked by a little loon. Not my proudest moment.
I'm calling to the silk-tongued liars, following the godless way, to the backdoor man with the backdoor plan, heading for the judgment day.
It's a real beautiful area. You've got tons of flowers, you've got the log jam, you've got moving water coming in, and it's just a beautiful setting. And there are a few people there. They had got a few fish and they were heading out. One of the biggest things about photography is anticipation, making sure that you're in the right place at the right time, putting yourself into a place to get a cool shot. As the father-son team were leaving in their float plane, I figured it'd be a cool opportunity to take advantage of the scenery, a subject being the float plane, mixed in with some of the log jam and some of the water there. Knowing that we had a little bit of wind coming from my back, they were going to basically be taking off right into us. So I went into the water, got settled so that when I was ready to take that shot, I wouldn't have ripples from me moving around.
My kind of work keeps me on the road. If Tuesday morning finds me less than good, I just tell my woman I did what I could. And I'm not going back. I'm not going back.
So once again, because of the cart, we had fishing waders, we had a fishing pole, lures.
nice to have somebody else there to help capture some different angles. There's a few segments within this whole piece that we kind of filmed the same thing, but both from different angles, kind of give each of those sequences kind of their own personality.
Oh, they're on the move. Get them while they're on the move. Ah, right in the mouth. Oh! The mouth on his back fin.
Taking pictures of the beautiful landscape, that's always awesome. But anytime you can incorporate that human element, get somebody in the frame, it immediately gives your audience something to latch onto. That morning when we woke up, I had anxiety about the whole trip coming out there, you know. I didn't really think that that cart was gonna be able to make it back, and I didn't really feel like pushing the bike cart all the way back. I had this idea that came to me in the middle of the night that was, I wonder how much it would cost to bring a float plane in here. And when I told Josh that, he shot out of bed.
That was like a dozen skipper.
Whoa! You didn't know your boy's a trained assassin. All right, let's go. Oh, yeah. Just like that, kids.
We had told the pilot it was two people, two bikes, and a bike cart. I had no idea he was gonna bring in a 10-person otter. When this plane landed, I thought it was Air Force One coming to pick up the president. Like, it was enormous. It was so nice to have a big plane coming to pick us up, not have to hike back.
I'm going home, I'm going home, I'm going home, I'm going home. Yeah, I'm going home, I'm going home, I'm going home, I'm going home. Inside me speaks so strong. I've been away for far too long. My life seems like a sad country song. I've been here and there and I've been around. I tried to find my middle ground. Now I had enough, Lord have mercy, I'm homeward bound.
So the plane is taking us to Nikiski, and Nikiski is quite a bit of ways away from Cooper Landing where we need to go. But thankfully, my father-in-law lives in Nikiski. He got to play a little part in the episode, so it was pretty cool to be able to include him in this, and very thankful that he was there to give us a ride back. As far as a wrap-up for it, oh man, a conclusion. What could go wrong? Well, we had a 10-hour bike ride in. We got attacked by a loon. We ended up getting trigonosis. So, I mean, what's the worst that could happen? I mean, I don't know. There's a lot of things that went wrong. However, Josh was a good sport about it. He was a good dude to hang out with for a couple of days. So, would I do this adventure again? Absolutely not. No.
Would I adventure with Josh? No, absolutely not. I'm just kidding.
Stink, bruh. I think I'm pretty happy to be leaving.
In a plane. Yeah.
Oh! I was figuring I was getting close to you anyway.
Well, I brought one sleeping bag, right?
No, I forgot mine. Oh, okay. On purpose.
Cold, Josh.
Hey, Dan. You know, you can take your helmet off now.
Nah. You can never be too safe out here.
Get some. Right?
GoPro, you take voice commands? GoPro, get me out of here. GoPro, stop the adventure.